It was with this leap in 2011 that David Hallberg made history in Moscow. Russians like Nureyev and Baryshnikov have famously come west to dance in the U.S., but as the prince in Sleeping Beauty, Hallberg became the first American principal dancer of the Bolshoi, the world's largest ballet company with more than 200 dancers, an institution that's remained at the center of Russian culture since its founding in 1776. Hallberg's performance was broadcast on live television and in the end won over both critics and a Russian fan base often leery of outsiders. He now splits his time between Moscow and the American Ballet Theater in New York, where we talked recently about his experience of ballet and the Bolshoi.
In Russia, it's in their blood, it's in their culture.
Mm-hmm.
And
unlike
anywhere else in the world.
Yeah.
It's this sort of pride and sense of purpose that, to me, is so inspiring to see.
The word Bolshoi means big, and the massive theater has survived everything from revolution to world war to the rise and fall of communism. Sarah Kaufman is a Pulitzer Prize-winning dance critic for The Washington Post.
Ballet to Russians is really like baseball or Hollywood to Americans. It's kind of the perfect vessel for the Russian soul. And you can compare the Bolshoi stage to Yankee Stadium.
If the Bolshoi is an unlikely place for a South Dakota-born, Arizona-raised kid to end up, Hallberg, now 31, credits Fred Astaire with setting him on the path.
Putting on the top hat.
Beginning at age 8 when he watched Top Hat on TV.
I was glued to the way he moved, sort of his suaveness, his seamless way of movement. And he was a huge inspiration to me when I was young.
That initial interest was followed by years of work with Ki-Wan Han, former director of the Arizona Ballet School, now with the Washington Ballet.
It's not just his physicality that was so impressive. Just the intensity of the way he worked was very impressive, too.
Teacher and pupil spent 6 days a week and countless hours focusing on strength, conditioning, flexibility, and mental toughness.
I'm not easy to work with because I always believe that the dance world, it's not an easy place.
He did not kill me with kindness.
Did he almost kill you with the amount of work?
Yes. My parents would sit in on my private lessons from time to time and almost call Child Protective Services. But I was so naive at the time. I didn't know how hard I was working. And that served as a sort of perfect ground to mold me into a ballet dancer.
To reach that goal, Hallberg also had to overcome something else, intense bullying.
I was the only boy in my environment that danced and, you know, made a target, bullying, and it was a very hurtful experience, but I never questioned it. I never doubted my love for it. I never decided, you know, whether I should quit or not to try and fit in because everyone was making fun of me. It was my respite. It was this sort of escape for me.
Dance critic Sarah Kaufman says all this preparation and Hallberg's ability to play a variety of roles have made him a special talent.
He's a thinking dancer. When you watch him in rehearsal, he's not so much focusing on the steps and he's not so preoccupied with his technique. He's thinking about what he's going to bring to the role in terms of the character. He can play the prince, he can play your lover, he can play your assailant, he can combine that all in one role. So there's no dancer I can think of, male or female, in the ballet world who's like that.
But a dark cloud has hung over Russian ballet since last January, when the Bolshoi's artistic director, Sergei Filin, the man who offered Hallberg a position at the historic company, was badly burned after an attacker threw sulfuric acid in his face, leaving Filin badly scarred and nearly blind. Bolshoi dancer Pavel Dmitrychenko was arrested for allegedly paying a convicted criminal to carry out the plot. Russian police say Dmitrychenko felt that he and his girlfriend, a fellow ballerina at the Bolshoi, were being overlooked by Filin and not given prominent roles. Reports have also suggested that Filin may have been a target because he was trying to make the Bolshoi more open, including recruiting dancers from outside Russia. David Hallberg was in the U.S. at the time of the incident, recovering from dance injuries.
It's an absolutely unacceptable act and attack. Sergei is a visionary in the sense that he is pushing Bolshoi Theater into the future and is pushing a new generation of dancers, and I can't support that sort of vision enough.
Do you have any fears yourself about going back?
Certainly. I would call myself naive if I didn't, I think. But I feel like I need to fulfill this sort of commitment that I made to the company.
But you say certainly you do have some fear.
Of course.
Because if the attacks had anything to do with the sort of idea of reaching beyond the Russianness, you're the personification of that.
I am, indeed. But I'm not going to let an attack like this derail my career. I mean, this is my career, and it doesn't last forever.
Hallberg, a prince of the ballet world now, also says he's eager to move beyond the prince roles in the future and help create new ballets both here and in Russia.